Good evening. The grieving daughter of one of the high country campers has come face to face with the man accused of killing her mother. Emma Davies sat just metres from the former JetStar pilot as she told the Supreme Court she knew Carol Clay was in a secret relationship.
Preparing to come face to face with her mother's alleged killer, the grieving daughter of slain camper Carol Clay kept her face hidden as she entered the Supreme Court, but then revealed all in the witness box, detailing she knew her mother had been in a secret relationship with Russell Hill while he was married to another woman. She said it was a very caring and very loving relationship. Emma Davies told the jury the high school sweethearts had been together for around 14 years when they went missing on a camping trip in Victoria's high country more than 4 years ago, sparking a public appeal for information. I indicated Russell was married, so I was concerned about the media release going out and showing them camping together. Greg Lynn maintains he's innocent of murdering the couple at a remote campsite called Bucks Camp, claiming they were accidentally killed in separate struggles over a shotgun and a knife. But the former JetStar pilot has admitted he covered up their deaths. The prosecution claims the 57-year-old loaded their bodies into a trailer and drove them to remote bushland hours away, returning months later to burn their remains. Michael Allen was one of the last people to speak to Mr. Hill alive the same day he was allegedly killed. What was his demeanour like? Asked the Crown prosecutor. He seemed like normal. Nothing seemed to be untoward. A fellow camper today described Mr. Hill as a kind-natured man, claiming he'd confessed he was struggling with retirement after a lifelong career in forestry, working in the very region where he later died. The jury can return a verdict on both counts of murder once the evidence is complete. Alternatively, they can find Mr. Lynn guilty of the lesser charge of manslaughter. Two weed sprayers and more fellow campers are expected to give evidence tomorrow. Rochelle Brown, 7 News.